In 2023, the average American contributed more tax dollars to the Pentagon than they did to K through 12 education, food stamps, and the child tax credit combined, by a lot. Now, this was an analysis done by the Institute for Policy Studies. They put out a report and it certainly is eye-opening. Let's get into the details, let's see what they found. So in 2023, the average US taxpayer contributed $4,308 for Medicare and Medicaid versus $5,109 for militarism and its support systems. That is pretty incredible, guys. And I'm really happy that they did this analysis because this is one of the issues that I'm curious about. Like, what does our government prioritize? And I think that our resources are incredibly important. I know that none of us enjoy seeing major portions of our income taken out of our paychecks every single time we get paid, but we're okay with it as long as that money is actually bettering the lives of our fellow Americans. But that doesn't seem to be the priority here. So militarism and its support systems, what does that mean? It's really important to give you all the context and details of how this was conducted and what they consider militarism to be. Well, that includes funding the Pentagon, nuclear weapons. Remember, it's not just building nuclear weapons, it's about maintaining nuclear weapons, which is an expensive thing to do. Aid to foreign militaries. Veterans programs, which the average taxpayer gave $1,155 for. I want to be clear that I am in favor of supporting our veterans, so I'm not against that, even though that is included in the analysis. Deportations and border militarization and federal spending on policing and prisons. Now in 2023, according to this analysis, the average US taxpayer contributed just $346 for K through 12 education versus $2,974 specifically for the Pentagon. Okay, so that shows you how little we invest in education versus how much we're funding the Pentagon. More than half of that money is allocated for the Pentagon, or half of that money that is allocated to the Pentagon, I should say, ends up going to defense contractors. So these are, you know, corporations that end up profiting through war. In 2023, the average US taxpayer contributed $516 for food stamps versus $1,748 for Pentagon contractors. So these are private contractors that have been hired by the Pentagon. And there's more. Let's break it down even further and name specific private defense contractors that are getting the money. So in 2023, the average US taxpayer contributed $110 for the child tax credit versus $249 for Pentagon contracts for Lockheed Martin specifically. See, it's one thing to have one giant figure, which is what we typically talk about when we discuss military funding, right? When we talk about money that goes to the Pentagon, money that goes to defense contractors. It's an entirely different thing to kind of break it down to a granular level and see what, on average, Americans are spending on very specific things, right? But there's more. So to be more specific, that tax money is going right to the pockets of pretty wealthy executives that head these companies or these defense contractors. So in 2021, the most recent year with complete stats, the nation's top five weapons makers, Lockheed Martin, Boeing, Raytheon, General Dynamics, and Northrop Grumman grabbed over $116 billion in Pentagon contracts and paid their top executives $287 million. Corporate giants like Boeing and Raytheon depend on government contracts for about half the dollars they rake in. For Lockheed Martin, General Dynamics, and Northrop Grumman, it's at least 70%. So the federal government, through our tax dollars, is propping up these defense contractors. I mean, it's not even close. The numbers speak for themselves.
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's gonna make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you, thank you.
And look, those numbers are outrageous on their own, and they're especially maddening in the context of US military aid to Israel, which has in fact spent 6 months inflicting a lot of pain, a lot of suffering, a lot of death in Gaza. So in 2016, the Obama administration had signed a 10-year agreement to supply Israel with $3.8 billion annually. Most of that in foreign military financing grants, which allow Israel to buy American weaponry. So that's the other thing. You know, there have been some supporters of Israel in Israel's government, of course, who have kind of spoken out against the critics of the Biden administration and his willingness to keep sending military aid to Israel. And what they tend to argue is, yeah, look, the US government is sending us money, but they don't understand that there are strings attached with that money. We must use that money to buy American weapons. I'm supposed to feel good about that? That doesn't make the situation any better. What that ends up being is a redistribution of wealth from American taxpayers and into the pockets of the executives at these defense contractors, at these companies that serve as defense contractors. And here's the real insult to injury here. The State Department said in March that it had received written assurances from Israel, as the United States requires of all countries that receive American arms, that the supplied weapons would be used in accordance with international humanitarian law. That has not been a reality. That has not been proven based on how Israel is conducting this war. Just today, UNICEF reported that they were hit with IDF fire as they were attempting to deliver humanitarian aid in Rafah. Luckily, in this particular case, and the last time I checked, I mean, the story might have changed since I read it a few hours ago. But luckily, based on what I read, no one died from that attack. But this is what, the 27th humanitarian aid convoy that's been attacked by the IDF? I mean, how many times does that need to happen? Anyway, that was just after Israel had, of course, killed seven World Central Kitchen workers who were trying to deliver humanitarian aid and had been coordinating exactly where they were in the Gaza Strip so the IDF wouldn't target them. But they were targeted with not one, not two, but three drone strikes. More importantly, the actions of the United States are making the world, in my opinion, less stable overall. But it's not just my opinion. Rising powers will be happy to cite US precedent as they assert their own expectations to international law. For as Gaza shows in a horrific manner, a world with exceptions to international law is one in which the least powerful suffer the most. And that's entirely true. And that destabilization is unfortunately happening on the US taxpayers' dime. So just something to keep in mind when you consider what is prioritized by our current American government, what gets funded the most, and question whether our money is well spent. Because when I take a look at the amount of money that's being sent to this brutal war in Gaza, I don't feel good about it. It doesn't make me feel that we're using our resources in the best possible way. And there is a growing community of American voters who feel that way, not just on the left, but you're starting to see that criticism, that critique on the right as well. And so I don't know what that is going to lead to. I don't know if anytime soon we're going to find ourselves with a government that actually prioritizes the American people over the Pentagon and wars abroad. We're not there yet, but there is a groundswell, a growing population of American voters on both sides of the political aisle who have had enough of this. And I don't blame them.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.